गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर फोर्थ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स टू सिक्स सेमेस्टर वी विल डिस्कस करैक्टरिस्टिक कर्व्स ऑफ जंक्शन फील्ड इफेक्ट ट्रांजिस्टर. सो हियर वी हैव टेकन द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एन चैनल जंक्शन फील्ड इफेक्ट ट्रांजिस्टर. सो वी हैव द सर्किट डायग्राम फॉर एन चैनल JFET. जस्ट एज इन केस ऑफ BJT, that is bipolar junction transistors, we have studied the characteristics of transistor in common emitter mode, common base mode and in common collector mode. In the same way, we will study the characteristic curves of junction field effect transistor. So here we have n-channel JFET, where this terminal is source, this one is drain, and this one is gate. As the FET is n-channel, so the gate will be of p-type. There will be two gate regions, p-type regions. And to measure the value of this output current, which is the drain current, milliammeter is used, which will measure the drain current. And as this drain, it will collect electrons carrying negative charge. So it will collect only if it will carry positive voltage with respect to source. So that is why we have applied voltage through this voltage source, with the help of which we are keeping this drain at higher positive potential with respect to source, so that this drain, it will keep on collecting electrons and thereby results in drain current. And here, as we know that this FET, as we have already discussed in our first lecture, that this FET is a voltage controlled device, means the current which flows through this N channel from this source to drain, it is controlled by the voltage. Controlled by which voltage? The voltage which we apply across this gate source junction. And the voltage which is applied across this gate source junction, that is the reverse bias voltage. So we always reverse bias this gate source junction to control the current through this channel. So that is why this gate, because this gate is p-type, in n-channel FET, so it will only be reverse biased when it will be connected to negative terminal of the battery and the source is at positive potential with respect to this gate. So this gate source junction is reverse biased, and because this gate source junction is reverse biased, and we know that the resistance of reverse biased junction is high, so because of the reverse biasing, its resistance will be high. So therefore, this gate current IG, it is approximately equal to 0 milliampere. That is why we haven't connected any milliammeter here. And here we will connect voltmeter to measure the potential across this gate source junction, which we have applied via this battery. So this is all about the circuit diagram of n-channel JFET. Now, as we are discussing n-channel FET, and we know that in n-channel FET, majority carriers are electrons. So the drain current, it will flow because of the flow of electrons. So in n-channel, majority carriers are electrons. So that is why the current, which is the drain current, it will flow because of the movement of electrons from source to drain. And this drain current, it is controlled by applying reverse bias voltage to the gate source junction because FET is a voltage control device. So just as in case of BJT, that is bipolar junction transistors, there are two types of characteristics, output characteristics and input characteristics. In the same way, in case of junction field effect transistors, there are two types of characteristics. First characteristics are known as output characteristics. And the second type of characteristics, they are known as transfer characteristics. Second one are known as transfer characteristics. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss output characteristics of the junction field effect transistor by taking N-channel FET as an example. So, what were the output characteristics in case of BJT? In case of BJT or in case of any device, output characteristics will be the characteristic curves obtained between output current and output voltage at constant input current or constant input voltage. They are known as output characteristics. Output characteristics means variation of output current by varying output voltage, but by keeping input values constant. And it can either be input current, as in case of BJT, because it is current control device. So output characteristics, they are controlled by keeping the current constant, input current constant. And in this case, as FET is the voltage control device, so here the output characteristics are the curves which are obtained by, or the curves or the study of the variation of output current with output voltage at constant input voltage, because it is a voltage control device. So the curves obtained between output current and the output voltage by keeping input voltage constant, those are known as output characteristics in case of junction field effect transistor. So now, what is the output current in case of junction field effect transistor? In case of junction field effect transistor, the output current is drain current ID. And what is the output voltage? It is drain source voltage. So we will vary the VDS, and by varying VDS, we'll check the variation of ID. But by keeping the value of input voltage, that is gate source voltage, constant. So this is the figure where we have obtained output characteristics of junction field effect transistor for various constant values of gate source voltage. So here you can see a graph is plotted between ID and VDS by taking VDS, that is output voltage of FET, along x-axis, and drain current in case of FET along y-axis. By keeping VGS fixed, corresponding to the different fixed values of VGS. So this is the curve obtained corresponding to VGS 0 volt. Then this is the curve corresponding to VGS minus 1 volt, minus 2 volt, minus 3 volt, and so on. So first we will study the curve obtained, characteristic curve obtained corresponding to the VGS is equal to 0 volt. And this output characteristics region, it is divided into three regions: ohmic region, saturation region, it is also known as pinch off region, and third one is breakdown region. And in all the three regions, this junction field effect transistor it functions differently. So first we will study that how FET will behave when gate source voltage or the voltage across the gate source junction is 0 volt, and this VGS, it is the reverse bias voltage applied across the gate source junction. It means there is no applied reverse bias. When VGS is equal to 0 volt, it means there is no applied reverse bias across the gate source junction. And if there is no bias across the gate source junction, it means the gate and the source terminal, they are short circuited. They are joined to one another directly. So this is the case when VGS is 0 volt. It means there will be no reverse bias of the two PN junctions because of VGS. But still, because there is PN junction, so there will be some depletion region. So now what we will do? We will increase the VDS. We will increase this VDS from 0 to higher volts, and we will see that how this drain current, it behaves accordingly, according to this VDS. So initially this VDS, it will also be 0 volt. When VGS is 0, VDS is 0, then what will happen? When VDS is 0, it means the drain, it is at 0 potential with respect to source. If drain is at 0 potential, it means the electrons which are to flow from source to drain, they carry negative charge, but they are not experiencing attractive force from the drain side, because drain will collect electrons only when it is at positive potential with respect to source. But here, starting initially, this drain, it is at 0 potential with respect to the source. It means there will be no attractive positive potential for electrons which will cause them to flow from source to drain. They will not be experiencing any attractive force or attractive positive potential from the drain side. So that is why there will be no movement of electrons from source to drain. So that is why drain current is also zero. So at this point, when VGS is zero and when VDS is zero, at that time ID is also zero. Then when you increase this VDS from zero to higher value, you can see by increasing from this point to this point, from this to this, when you increase this VDS, the current ID, it is also increasing. Why? Because if you are increasing this VDS, what is this VDS? It is the positive potential of drain with respect to source. It means you are increasing the positive potential at drain. If the positive potential at drain will increase, then more and more number of electrons, they will flow from source to drain, because the attractive positive potential is increasing. So as more and more number of electrons, they are flowing from source to drain, it means this drain current will also increase. So that is why this drain current, it is increasing. And here you can see that this junction field effect transistor, because of this curve from O to A, it is just behaving like the ohmic resistor. It is obeying Ohm's law from this point O to A, because here the drain current ID, it is varying linearly by varying the voltage VDS. And also, as we have already studied, that the resistance of the N channel is uniform throughout. So what will happen after this point? Why after this point the current is not increasing? It is just constant. What happens after this point? That current is not increasing, it is constant even when you are increasing VDS. So now we will study that what will happen when VGS is kept constant at 0 volt means there is no applied reverse bias across the gate source junction, but now we are increasing VDS beyond 0 volt. So as I have already told you that because of the positive potential of drain with respect to source, the electrons in N channel, they will start moving from source to drain because of the attractive potential. And with continuous increase in VDS, this drain current ID, it will also increase because of the increased number of flow of electrons from source to drain. So I have already told you that, so from point O to A, this N channel, it behaves like an ohmic resistor, where the drain current ID, it varies linearly, it increases linearly with increase in the voltage VDS. Also, the channel has uniform resistance throughout. So now we will study that what happens after point A, why the current is not increasing after point A, why it is keeping constant. So what happens at point A? Pinch off occurs. Now you will think that even when the gate source voltage, the reverse bias voltage applied at the gate source junction, even when it is 0 volt, how the pinch off will occur? It is because even when the gate source junction, it is short circuited, means we have no applied reverse bias here, even then this PN junction, it is reverse biased. How? Because this drain, it is at a positive potential with respect to source. When you will keep on increasing the VDS, what will happen? The positive potential of this drain with respect to source, it will increase. And as the resistance is uniform throughout, so you can suppose that as it is behaving like a resistor in this ohmic region, it means we have a resistor. It is a, this N channel, it is divided into resistances, equal resistances. But this upper end, it is at positive potential, and this lower end, it is at negative potential or lower potential. Suppose the potential at drain, it is plus 2 volt. Because of this positive potential at drain with respect to source, what will happen? The electrons, they will move from source to drain. And if electrons are moving from source to drain, the conduction current, conventional current, it will flow from drain to source. The direction of ID will be from drain to source. So if current is flowing from drain to source, conventional current, when current, it will flow from this resistance, what will happen? Voltage drop will occur across this resistance. And if voltage drop across this resistance occurs, then at this point, the voltage will be smaller than this point. Then again, when current will flow from this resistance, then what will happen? Again, voltage drop will occur. And voltage drop, suppose now from 1.5, voltage will drop to 1 volt. And then again, when the current, it means when the current is flowing along the length from drain to source, at each point, voltage drop occurs. So because of that, the upper end, you can see this end, it is at higher potential, which is 1.5 volt, for example, and this lower end, it is at lower potential, that is 1 volt. This is N channel. This N channel, it is reverse biased by plus 1.5 volt here, but the N channel on this side, it is reverse biased by minus 1 volt. It means the regions which are near the drain, The region of this PN junction, which is near the drain, it is reverse biased by more positive potential. And the regions which are near to the source, they are reverse biased by smaller positive potential. So that is why reverse bias at the ends which are near to the drain is high than the reverse bias at the ends which are near to the source. So because of that, this depletion layer, it will be like this. The width of this depletion layer, it will increase to a larger extent on the drain side, but its width will be small on the as we move from drain to source. Why? Because reverse bias is decreasing. So that is why we are saying that the reverse bias or the voltage drop occurs along the length of this N channel FET. So what will happen? The upper region which is near to the drain, it will be reverse biased with higher positive potential, and this lower region which is near to the source, it is reverse biased by lower positive potential. So which results in the change in the width of depletion region. So now what will happen? When you will increase this VDS, then the reverse bias near the drain side, it will also increase than the reverse bias near the source side. So therefore, there will be increase in the width of depletion region near the drain side. And what we are doing? We keep on increasing this VDS. So at one point, this VDS, it is increased to a point. What is happening? By increasing this VDS, the depletion region, it is keep on growing. It keeps on growing. And at one time, when this VDS, it is increased to an extent that the two depletion layers, they will touch each other. And pinch off occurs even when VGS is 0 volt. So that value of VDS at which this pinch off occurs, that is known as pinch off voltage. But here you can see, actually what is the meaning of pinch off, where current becomes 0. But here, in this case, when this pinch off occurs, the current is maximum and it remains constant even after that. Why is it so? Why the current is not 0? So pinch off occurs even when the current, drain current, it is maximum, it does not drop to 0. So here this drain current, it is maintaining a saturation level which is denoted by IDSS. So what is the meaning of this? That this is the current which is flowing from drain to source when gate source junction is short circuited. This second S, it means the gate source junction is short circuited. So it is the maximum value of current which flows when VGS is equal to 0 volt and VDS is equal to VP, or VGS is equal to greater than VP. So the maximum value of current which is flowing from drain to source, that is known as IDSS. So why it is not 0? At pinch off, current must be 0. Why it is not 0? It is maximum. So in reality, what happens? Even at that time, a very small channel, it still exists. And through that channel, some amount of electrons, they flow. So that is why this current ID, it does not drop off to 0. For a second or for a moment, when pinch off occurs, there will be absence of drain current. And when for a moment, these two processes, they go side by side. So when for a moment there is absence of drain current, then what will happen? There will be no voltage drop across the length of the N-channel JFET. So it will remove the varying levels of reverse bias along the length of the PN junction. This varying levels of reverse bias, it will be removed by the absence of drain current for a moment. So this will result in the loss of the depletion region back to the normal position that was pinched off initially. So the current will start flowing again. So that is why this constant current is maintained after that. So when you increase this VDS greater than VP, this IDSS is maintained. So during this region, as you are increasing this VDS, but this current, it almost remains constant. This saturation current, it almost remains constant. It means during this saturation region, this junction field effect transistor, it acts as constant current source. And then when you have increased this VDS to a larger extent, at that point it will break down, and almost at single voltage all the bonds, they will be broken down and the large amount of current will flow. So that is known as breakdown region. And at that time current is increasing but voltage is constant. So in breakdown region, this junction field effect transistor, it works as constant voltage source. Now what will happen when you will increase the reverse bias across this gate source junction, that is from 0 to minus 1 volt, minus 2 volt, minus 3 volt and so on. Because of the increase in the reverse bias across the gate source junction, what will happen? The two PN junctions, they will be reverse biased, and then you will increase VDS. So the two depletion regions, they will touch each other at much smaller voltage of VDS than the previous case. So saturation will be attained but at smaller value of VDS is equal to VP. So by increasing the reverse bias across the gate source junction, the pinch off voltage decreases. Because the conduction channel, it becomes narrow because of the increase in reverse bias and because of increase in positive value of VDS. And at one point, when this VGS, it has made minus VP volts, means it is made equal to the pinch off voltage. The voltage at gate source junction, it is made equal to the negative of the pinch off voltage. What will happen? Whatever be the value of VDS, because of this reverse bias which is equal to VP volts, the drain current will remain zero throughout, and it is known as cutoff region. So cutoff region is the region when this VGS, it is made equal to minus VP volts. At that time, whatever be the value of VDS, because when VDS is equal to 0, is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on, pinch off has already occurred. So that is why this drain current, it will stay 0. And this is known as cutoff region. So this is all about the output characteristics of junction field effect transistor. In the next lecture, we'll discuss transfer characteristics of junction field effect transistor.